How may I serve you, Master? Hello, Mrs. Millet. Hello, Mrs. Millet.
careful.
Better get out of here if you know what's good for you.
Hey there.
Howdy. Better get out of here. The bosses of the Omergas? Omernas? The ones that run Guma. Someone killed them.
Thanks for bringing the NCR to town, stranger. Things are finally looking up for Prim. You'd better get out of here.
You better get out of here if you know what's good for you.
Thank you.
You better get out of here if you know what's good for you. You better get out of here. Keep moving. You better get out of here.
can't get any work. Pablo.
Done us a great service.
Hungry for grub? See ya.
Done us a great service.
Thanks.
You've given us the ability to touch the soul. Thank you. I can take care of this robot problem for you. Just saying.
pleased to meet you, and we'll get acquainted. Or, if you have more important things to do than talk to old Festus, say goodbye. New in town, partner? Well, let old Festus give you the lay of the land. If you're here to redeem your sunset sarsaparilla stars, dump them into the slot in the barrel below and I'll count them up. If you don't know what sunset sarsaparilla stars are and think old Festus is just shooting his mouth off, say star info. If you're here to challenge old Festus to a game of lucky horseshoes, say I feel lucky. Lastly, if you're here about the health advisory that aired on Channel 6 recently, say silly old advisory. If this is your first rodeo with the old horseshoes, say, how do I play? Otherwise, say, lucky horseshoes to begin. All right, let's play, partner. Press the blue button to draw a card, the red button to hold, or the yellow button to quit. Looks like you got an ace, partner. Yeah, you're doing well. But old Festus ain't out of this yet. Old Festus is gonna draw. Looks like I got a two, partner. See that? Old Festus is an old hand at this. Your turn, partner. Draw, hold, or quit. Looks like you got a seven, partner. Yeah, you're doing well. But old Festus ain't out of this yet. Old Festus is gonna draw. Looks like I got a two, partner. Drat! Old Festus needs more than that to catch you. Your turn, partner. Draw, hold, or quit. Okay, partner. Guess it's up to me to catch up. Old Festus is gonna draw. Looks like I got a 10, partner. Looks like I win, partner. You did well. But old Festus did a bit better. If you'd like to play again, say, play again. Your turn. Looks like I win.
Now, the threat of legal action
sure the recipe was being followed to the letter. The man happily agreed, thinking the drink would make him rich, and the stranger promised to meet him by sundown the next day. The next morning, the sheriff stopped by and reported that the stranger's body was found on the side of the town road. He'd been killed by bandits. The man, cursing his luck, closed the saloon early that day, just as the sun began to set. But after he'd locked the doors, he turned around to find an unfamiliar bottle on the bar with a note beneath it. The note was sealed with blue wax in the shape of a star. Opening it, the man found it contained a recipe for a sarsaparilla-flavored drink. Sampling the bottle's contents and finding it singularly delicious, the man gave silent thanks to his mysterious benefactor, wherever he was. Being an honorable man, the saloon owner paid for the stranger's funeral, thinking it was the least he could do to repay him. The saloon owner went on to become rich selling the new drink, and to this day, some bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla have a blue star under their caps. Some say the saloon owner ordered it done in honor of the stranger. Others say it's the stranger sampling the bottles like he promised. And that's the legend of the star. Hope you enjoyed it, and hope you continue enjoying Sunset Sarsaparilla. The Sunset Sarsaparilla Company has received a number of complaints regarding the prize awarded for handing in Sunset Sarsaparilla stars. Therefore, we have seen fit to provide another prize that we feel will placate the most discriminating customer. Just head through the double doors and follow the hallway to your left to the very end. An attendant will be there to present your prize directly. We at the Sunset Sarsaparilla Company would once again like to thank you for your patronage.
to show for it. I guess the joke's on me. Probably shouldn't have killed all those people. Probably should have stayed at home and taken care of my mom. She always used to say people who murder and steal die bad in the end. Said they...
Come on.
Didn't know anyone would willingly walk into this place. Not unless they were looking for trouble. What's your story? I understand that Cook was behind it all. I kept my head down the whole time. Didn't want any part of it. I stuck around, figuring the NCR would show up and put things back the way they were. No sense in making myself look guilty, right? I was a sheriff, believe it or not, for a small town far to the west of here. Short version is that sometimes justice is a little slow. I helped speed it up one too many times. I'm not sorry for anything I did, but I will do the time. Fair enough trade, if you ask me. Some kind of anti-NCR rebel. Some people just... He went north with some of the other guys. Right now, Eddie and his boys were...
Hi there. Looking to... Our patrols are always bringing more stuff in. Take a look. Pleasure doing business with you. Hi there. Looking to... Our patrols are always bringing more stuff in. Take a look. Another satisfied customer? Later.
Maybe they can win this war.
Keep an eye on your stuff.
Thank you.
hear the Great Khans got massacred again. No survivors. Smells like shit. We're safer than in the wastes.
Going to place me a good bet at the Thorn. Because that's the law of the land. You never know when someone's going to stab you in the back, and I like mine upright. Maybe one day, stranger, when you've seen all I've seen, done all I've done, you'll sooner trust a rad scorpion than a new face in the world. You got a sharp eye on you. I take it you like guns, huh? Question is, can you handle more than just a weapon? I mean, you've got to know yourself before you can truly know the gun. So let's see it, stranger. Do you know yourself? Sure thing. Can't go anywhere else.
Can I help you with something, stranger? We've been here for a few years, just looking for a place we can call our own. Life's harsh, but still, it beats the hell out of the desert. We've got numbers, we've got food, and we've got trade. That's progress, stranger. Keep your nose to the ground, stranger, that's what. Mind your own business and let us mind our own. Are we clear? If you got a mind to loot the old H&H Tools factory, don't even bother. That place is sealed tighter than a rad scorpion's bunghole. Every salvager who tries gets blown up, flattened or gutted by traps. Then he starts to stink up the town, and we're the ones to clean up the mess. That's right, the H&H Tools factory on the main drag. It's been sealed for ages, and it's lousy with traps. Still, might be something valuable to you. Name's Crandon, stranger. I keep an eye out for trouble around here. Folks that don't belong. Murderers, rapists, extortionists, and everything in between. You know, business as usual in North Vegas, stranger. NCR, did you just crawl out from under a rock? Those folks only care about their business, their people, and their pockets. NCR's order? Don't make me laugh, stranger. We work this land, we own these streets, and we yank up the bad weeds ourselves. Got it? Jules, myself, and a few others patrol the streets and sewers. Any punks come up out of the rest of the city, we give them the runoff. You want to help us out? What makes you think we want you around here, huh? That's the kind of stuff I like to hear, stranger. All right, we could use someone like you. Some squatters decided to take space where they don't belong, over by the playground. We'd prefer to keep them off the streets and out of sight. Maybe you could go and talk to them, convince them to see things our way. I like your speed, stranger. Let me know when that's done.
Piss off.
What do you want? Oh, really? And how are you gonna make us? Hey, don't worry. I was just kidding. We're going, right, boys?
Maybe they can win this war out.
Have you taken care of those squatters? That's good to hear. Can't ever be too careful with strangers around here. Good work with those newcomers. I think you can handle more serious business with more serious rewards. There's a handful of greasers down in the sewers causing trouble. They ain't packing too much iron, but I'd like them dealt with all the same. Glad to hear it. Let me know when they're gone.
Keep an eye on the stuff.
NCR should head back to the land.
What the hell are you looking at, punk? Oh, yeah? Fuck off, asshole. Wait, you've got a point. All right, fellas, let's get out of this shithole.
I'm sure they're people.
Have you run off those greasers? Great work. I gotta make sure this place doesn't eat itself from the inside. You know, this time I may actually need a gun with a brain. Talk to Mrs. Hostetler. She's near the Crimson Caravan. I think her daughter's making bad friends, the kind that'll slit your throat in the dark.
Prim has a new ship. What are you doing here? Get out before I blow your head off. He did, huh? All right. What do you want? He should really mind his own business. Crandon's good to keep scum in check, but he ain't exactly subtle. If you're good at snooping around, then I could use you. I need to find out what my daughter's up to. She's been frequenting the square in North Vegas, probably hanging out with street scum. I want to know more about her new friends. All right, we've got a deal then. I'll make sure to compensate you for your time, if you find anything useful.
What's eating you? Alice.
Oh, yeah. I've seen her around here much too often as of late. I reckon she's been hanging out with Andy and his crew. Try the gray. Beats me why people go into that forsaken thing. At least with huts and sewers, you know they ain't crumbling on top of your head.
The bosses of the Omer gas? Gas? The ones that run Gamora? Someone killed them. What the fuck you want, huh? Oh yeah? What for? So what? I don't give a shit about what you like. Go cry to your mama. Maybe they don't want to talk to you. Maybe they ain't here anymore. Maybe you asked too many questions, stranger. This is our turf. Don't even try to snoop around or I'll fucking kill you right here, right now. What? You gotta be kidding me. Fuck. Why do I always gotta fix someone else's crap around here?
What are you looking at, huh? Answer me, or I'll get trigger happy real quick. You think I give a shit? Has it crossed your mind that Alice is all the way in this with me? Maybe because I'm so good looking. Maybe because her mother's trying to break her back, planting crops that die from rads as soon as they're in the ground. Or maybe she's just a dupe. Why do you even care? She's happy making her own way in the world. And you think that's worth her happiness? Go on and tell her then. Watch what happens when you crush her dreams. And how exactly would you do that? Oh, boy.
Thank you. back off. I know how to use this gun, and I'm not afraid to shoot if you try anything. I've put up with their shit long enough. No more. I'll kill them if they get in my way. Then what the hell do you want? Don't try anything, I mean it. Okay, but this better not be a trick. What are you talking about? Andy wants to help me leave this hole, doesn't he? That son of a bitch! I'll take the money and I'll kill him too. She's guarding it, I know she is. She locked the bedroom door, like that's gonna stop me. I've got a gun, I'm gonna make her give it to me. The money, yes. It's mine and nobody can stop me from getting it. You too? Think I'm just a little girl? I'll show you. Hey!
Baby, I'm sorry. Oh no.
Back off. I know. Then what the hell do you want? Okay, but this better not be a trick. What are you talking about? Andy wants to help me leave this hole, doesn't he? She's guarding... That... Yeah, okay. I'll shoot the lock off the door and then... Ah, damn it! I can't do it, I can't. She deserves it and worse, but I can't hurt my own mother. Fine, take it. But what the hell am I supposed to do now? Maybe you're right, but what will they think? How can I look them in the face ever again? Well, I guess I don't deserve any better, huh? So be it.
I was blind to what was happening in my own family. We don't have much, but please take this. Yes, I suppose you're right. Please, take this. It's half of our savings. We'll manage, somehow, as we've always done. Take care of yourself out there, and if you ever need a friendly hand, know that folks around here will always welcome you.
Hey. The Legion being wiped out at Nelson gave us some breathing room. Hopefully the brass will use that. Captain Parker, I'm in charge of this camp. This here's where folks go when their luck runs out. Drifters up from the Republic, locals that can't turn a dime, drunken reprobates from all around. And if you don't have the caps to get onto the Strip, odds are you'll end up here. Well, I am a little short-staffed. Maybe you could give me a hand. Some people have gone missing from the camp lately. I haven't seen any signs of violence or heard about any feuds. They just up and vanished. I've also got Keith and his gambling to deal with. I know that skunk's cheating folk out of their savings. I just can't prove it. They never seem to have much in common. That's why I didn't notice it sooner. Young folks, old folks, men, women, all disappearing. I remember a family with a little blonde girl. She never talked much, but she always carried this little stuffed teddy bear. Seem to recall a lot of them did business with those scavengers over on the west side, Dermot and St. James. Keith's a two-bit hustler. He runs a gambling operation out of his shack. Ask me, he wins way too often to be playing fair. I suspect he's running drugs, too. I just can't prove it. Maybe you can find something. Talk to him, poke around his shack, something.
Why are you talking to me, man? I'm trying to relax here. Got it? I don't know a thing about no missing refugees from that Aerotech camp. Go cry to somebody else. Yeah, well, I must have heard rumors. And, fuck you. You got nothing on me and Dermot.
I hear a troublesome Legion camp got razed to the ground.
Something I can help you with, stranger? Some people... Have you found out what happened to the... Let's see. A bear. Yes. This belonged to the little girl, so that's a direct connection to the missing people. And this ledger. I know these names. Nephi and Cook are major players with the Fiends. Dermot and St. James must be working with them. Thank you for your help. I'll make sure those sick bastards get what's coming to them. Here, you've earned this.
Hey, fellow, welcome to the Topps Hotel and Casino. I'm gonna have to ask you to hand over any weapons you might be carrying. Smooth and easy, just the way I like it. Don't worry, they'll be as safe as kittens till you're ready to leave. Oh, and a friendly word of advice. If you happen to stumble across any weapons during your stay here, well, just don't wear them openly. You dig? Now that we got that little business out of the way, what can I do to make your Topps experience the Topps? Hello?
What in the goddamn... Let's keep this in the groove, hey? Smooth moves, smooth. Hello? It was you smashed up the Omertas? You did that? Shit. I can't do that, baby, and you know it. There's a lot of angles to this caper. Complexities aplenty. But plenty of action, too. Enough for both of us. But we don't jabber about that out here in public. What say you and me cash out? Go somewhere that's more private-like. Any questions you got, I'll answer. To start, I'll comp you the presidential. Best suite in the house. You deserve a taste of the VIP lifestyle. I'll hang out down here for a while to make everything look business as usual, then come to you. Any questions you got, I'll answer. Guaranteed. If that's what it takes to win your trust, that's what it takes. Follow me. Keep those hands where I can... Now that you and me's got some privacy, I gotta ask, how is it that you're still living? Yeah, hello. Well, serves me right for using a 9mm. Once you were vertical, how'd you track me down? To think I deemed that flint box my lucky charm. Oh, the irony. I guess that's enough scratching around at first base. Tell me, which way is the wind gonna blow? You've got a crazy drop on me here, baby, that's for sure. If killing's what you came for, this would be the time. But baby, you'd be disappointing me. All the trouble you went through to arrange this shindig must be something more you're after. You got questions, I got answers. It's the house edge, baby. Literally. It's what Mr. House needs to stack the odds in his favor. Baby, ease off the gas. The chip belongs in the hands of someone who can use it, as in me, not you. You'll get a piece of the action and a sweet one, but the chip sticks with me. It's some kind of data storage device, Dig. So it's the data on the chip that's platinum, not the chip itself. Trouble is, the chip don't fit any computer I've found. Must require special hardware. It has something to do with the Securitrons, I know that much. Upgrades their hitting power, gives them heft. Might be slightly useful if you're looking to defend the strip from Caesar's Legion or the NCR. Or maybe both. Broad strokes, change in management. The Securitrons are where it's at. I need a way to control them and a way to beef up their hitting power. I get those two ducks in a row, Vegas can defend itself versus all comers. NCR, Caesar's Legion, it won't matter. Baby, the odds may look long, but that's just because we ain't done rigging them. I won't toss the dice until we are. I've gleaned a lot working with Mr. House. He was a good cat to swing with. I still got a lot to learn, but it's coming together. Baby, do you not understand the level of game here? What I did to you was rotten, but if you think House, the NCR, or Caesar won't kill to put Vegas in their pocket, I really did blow out your brains. It's a game, and games have winners and losers. I prefer the former. How about you? Something else you wanted to know? Yeah, it's a tricky world out there. I'll tell it to you straight. A good cat to swing with, or was, until he stopped mewing. It was House's big idea to resurrect the Strip. He recruited the three families as muscle, showed us how to set up casinos, negotiated with the NCR. None of this in person, mind you. Did all of his talking through those Securitrons of his. But lately, the silence is deafening. The robots collect House's share of the take every week, and life goes on. Ain't exactly what I'd call leadership. We're the definition of cool, baby. We know how to swing. Folks come to us to learn how to enjoy themselves. Of the three families, we're the only ones with the heart and savoir-faire to run the Strip on our own. personally, they give me the heebie-jeebies. There's such a thing as being too polite, if I may this, my pleasure that. Don't get me wrong, that resort of theirs is strictly ring-a-ding. But my guts say, don't go in the basement. A nation of meddlers trying to muscle in on our action. Well, we got muscles too, and smarts besides. Only reason the NCR hasn't busted up our scene is they're a little afraid of Mr. House and a lot afraid of Caesar. If the NCR beats the Legion at Hoover Dam, they'll turn on us and claim the Strip. And we don't have the muscle to beat them. Not yet. Meanwhile, they're all that's keeping Caesar's Legion at bay. Plus, NCR soldiers and citizens are our best customers. It's complicated. You help me, and before long, the chairman will rule all of Vegas, dig? With enough robot muscle to back it up. You'll get a sweet, juicy cut of that action. But until that day comes, I'll keep you on retainer and pay bonuses for special missions. How's that sound? Like I said, once the chairmen are running... Jackpot, baby. I knew we'd see eye to eye. Here's a start on your retainer. Don't spend it all in one place, and the prez is yours for as long as you want it. When you're ready to saddle up, come find me down on the casino floor, and we'll plan the next step of this caper. Ring-a-ding, baby. Ta-ta.
Not my yeah, you and me both.
Love our next segment.
Now that you and me's got...
...found shot in the head near Good Springs has reportedly regained consciousness and made a full recovery. Now that's a delivery service you can count on.
I guess that's enough...
...the influx of displaced residents to the
Baby, you're the boss. In the meantime, enjoy the high life. Room service is... You got questions?
Mad about the boy.
You help me and... Guess I should have seen that coming.
Oh my.
Found you.
I heard Troublesome Legion Camp got razed to the ground.
Hey, hey, welcome, welcome, welcome to the finest entertainment experience in New Vegas. My name is Tommy Torini, and how can I make your day? Well, it was my idea. Well, me and the rest of the Rat Pack boys. We took it to Benny, and he thought it was a good idea. A few years later, here we are, the best show in New Vegas. Benny, he's an all right cat, you dig? He don't got much musical talent, but he knows how to run a business. When he's around, anyways. Well, now, you didn't hear this from Tommy, but Benny likes to go off on a bender now and then. Usually he's only gone a couple of days, but this last time, nobody saw him for almost a month. Ask me, I think he's got a dame from Gamora, holed up in a suite, because nobody ever saw him leave it. Well, apart from serving as a talent manager, show schedule, and all-around man in charge of this fine theater, I happen to be its headline act. Every night from 8 till midnight, come on by to see the Rat Pack Review live, only right here at the Aces Theater. Well, acts are a bit thin on the ground right now, but every night from 8 to midnight, we got the Rat Pack Review. Songs, dancing, jokes, we got it all. Sure, baby, sure. Tommy's always looking for new talent to bring to the Aces. Tell you what, you see any good acts while you're out wandering, give them my card. If they work out, I'll give you a 3% cut of the door. Just swing back by as you recruit folks. I'll get you your bread. Ooh, a shop customer. All right. All right, 5% it is.
The eyes of the mighty Kaiser are upon you. He admires your accomplishments and bestows upon you the exceptional gift of his mark. Any crimes you may have perpetrated against the Legion are hereby forgiven. Kaiser will not extend this mercy a second time. My lord requires your presence at his camp at Fortification Hill. His mark will guarantee your safe conduct through our lands. Seek Kaisar by way of Cottonwood Cove, south of Nelson. The Corsair Kuluth will be waiting.
Hey, you there. I have a message for you. It's from Ambassador Crocker. Very important. Here you go.
Khan's got the hint. We've shown everyone.
Hey, come on, pal, I'm trying to put... All right, then make it snappy, kid. This isn't exactly a... Yeah? Hey, you're all right. Tell him I'll do it for 100 a night. No, 50. No, 20. 10. Just don't rob me, I'll do it. Whoa, geez, what was I thinking? You're right. I gotta go in there with a cool head. Tell them how much I'm really worth.
Those cops. Oh, please don't kill me. I swear I'll have... Wait, you don't work for Mr. Bishop, do you? Sorry, it's just you look like his type, you know? You got that hard-ass wasteland explorer thing going on. Oh, so you have heard of me. Yeah, that's right. I was the big draw at the Shark Club. People used to pay hundreds of caps to see me. Really? The tops, huh? Well, it's no Shark Club, but I hear security on the strip is real tight. Even Mr. Bishop wouldn't hit a joint like that. I'll check it out. Thanks.
Thank you.
Howdy there, partner. Son, where I come from, a man doesn't just walk up to another man and offer him a job without even knowing him. What's your game? Uh-huh. Sorry, stranger. Just not sure I trust that kind of charity from somebody I don't even know. Well, I was born in a little town out... Maybe it's time to give these tired old bones a rest. All right, show me what you've got. Much obliged to you, friend.
Hey, you're the one who's been going around help.
I've got my eye.
Well, if it isn't my number one fan. Too bad I got this ironclad contract with the Garretts. They'll never let me out of it. Huh. Good luck. Garrett's a tough, mean son of a bitch. He's not likely to give up. Let me know if you make any headway.
I hear Benny got force-fed a little slice of heaven. Man, what I would have paid to see that loathsome little weasel eat it. Now, why would I want to do that? His performances make me quite a lot of money. I suppose you've got a point. Plenty of Brahmin on the prairie and all that. Fine, I'll cut him loose. He's all yours.
Hey, that's great. We'll get some supplies sent over today as a show of good faith. Once our stills are upgraded, we'll never be short on liquor for our patrons. If Jacob Hoff is sober, we might even have a few new drinks on tap. Most might view us as drug-dealing enablers around here. But honestly, we care about our patrons. It's bad business for people to get addicted. We've got enough crime in Freeside without a bunch of strung-out junkies robbing traders and gamblers to afford their next fix.
There.
Any luck with Garrett yet? Really? You mean I'm finally out of this shithole? That's great. Thank you.
I've got my eye.
Hey, fellow. Oh, now the big...
Those cons got the hint.
Well, well, well. If it ain't the best love cat on the strip in my theater, what could Tommy... Cowboy act. Yeah. He dropped on in here not too long before you. He's got chops, baby, real chops. And I ain't just... And like we agreed, here's your fee. 5% of the cut comes to 166 caps. Don't spend them all in one plate. You talking about Mr. Isaac? Damn, baby, when you bring them in, you bring them in. That cat's gonna bring me money like you. Here's your 5%, baby. You. That comedian, you mean? Yeah. He was a hell of a haggler. Cost me a pretty cap. Hope. That ugly mug with the razor tongue? Dig it, baby. He'll... You...
We've shown everyone that these are our new territories.
Well, howdy, partner. Good to see you again. Boss is waiting for you upstairs, so get a move on. I see you brought some friends. Sorry, partner, but they're gonna have to stay outside. Come back soon now. Where to, partner?
Busy courier, haven't you? You take your obligation to deliver a package very seriously, an ethic for which I am grateful. I will admit, when you ignored my invitation, I predicted negative outcomes. But you have a way of exceeding expectations, don't you? Well, enough. Let's have the chip then. I'll be happy to satisfy your every curiosity once the Platinum Chip has been delivered. Such a small thing, isn't it? And yet so capacious, so very dear. Decades of hiring salvagers out west to search for this little relic in the ruins of a place called Sunnyvale. Back then, anyway. That's where the chip was printed, on October 22nd, 2077. It was to have been hand-delivered to me here at the Lucky 38 the next day. but the bombs fell first. Suffice it to say, the delivery was never made. A great deal shall be happening, a cascade of events with you taking a central role. At the moment, however, all you need to do is take the elevator all the way down to the bottom level. You'll understand soon enough. Are rarely so educational, don't you think? I've since broadcast the upgrade to every Securitron in range of my transmitters, and I must say, it's causing quite a stir down on the Strip. I'm surprised you can still underestimate me after everything you've seen. I haven't shown my hand. I've shown one card. I've given my enemies a single provocative datum upon which to fixate. They have no idea what other cards I'm holding. It's a strong hand, believe me. I dealt it to myself. To secure the future of New Vegas, I must have your assistance. The work ahead is dangerous, but you weather danger well. The next step will require you to infiltrate Caesar's camp at Fortification Hill. Absolutely not. Caesar is of great use to me. I don't want you harming a hair on that man's head. Assuming you could find one. I want you to open a hatch in the basement of the derelict weather station atop Fortification Hill. You'll recognize it on sight. The hatch bears the logo of the Lucky 38, same as the Platinum chip. You can't, but the chip can. The hatch will recognize the Platinum chip and open sesame. Something very important. I wouldn't want to spoil the surprise, so don't bother asking. Here, take the platinum chip again. You will need it. Upon arrival at the fort, it's likely that you'll be searched and the chip taken from you. Don't worry, it will come back to you.
Congratulations, partner. You can bring your friends, too. Be like a little clubhouse for the gang you put together. Just bear in mind, you're the only one gets to see the boss. Any friends you got, they can wait in the suite. Enjoy the digs, partner. They're plenty fancy. Casino floor.
Excuse me, but are you the courier who caused all of that trouble in the tops? Oh, great. The followers of the apocalypse, well, some of us anyway, have been interested in Mr. House's technology, how he stays alive. Of course, no one else is allowed inside the Lucky 38, so no one knows what's going on. Well, except for you. Right. We just want to find out what sort of technology Mr. House has used to stay alive for all these years. It could be of great benefit to the people we try to help, many of whom suffer from hard-to-diagnose illnesses. Really? Oh, I wasn't expecting you to agree so easily. That's great. Here, take this packet sniffer. It'll allow us to intercept data on Mr. House's network. You might have to manually remove the encryption from his data network, but hopefully you won't have too much trouble. Good luck.
Recent disturbance at Gamora.
Hey, have you been able to bug Mr. House's network yet? It looks like we've started getting reports from the tower's network. I'm sure the others will be able to make some sense of this. Oh, what the hell? The bug went offline. Damn it! I swear to God that old man has thought of everything. Well, it looks like this was all for nothing. But you did your best. I appreciate the help.